Hello friends, welcome to BSC Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button and let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about entomology's crop-wise pests. I am going to teach you the pests of rice, especially the borers as well as leafholders. If you want to see the above one, you can be able to see that in the last of the video. So, which is a sucking pest of rice. So let's move for the borers. So I have given their classifications of common name, scientific name, family and orders as borers, for borers and leaf feeders in line. So I directly move on to the paddy stem borer first one. So the scientific name is Chiropaga insectulus. So the major damage they are caused by paddy stem borers or dead heart as well as dried white ears. So these are the major symptoms which are shown once if the rice or paddy which is said to be affected by paddy stem borers. And while seeing about the distribution, they are said to be found in Asian countries, in Tamil Nadu. The occurrence of pest occur mainly in Tanjavur, Tiruchi, Madurai, Tirunelveli, during the districts at Samba and Thoradi crops. And while seeing about their characteristics, the eggs are laid in mosses and they are said to be covered with buff colored hairs which are removed from the insect bodies, and larva which is said to be pale yellow in color. Pupa is said to be a silkened cocoon, and adult they used to have the difference between both male and female. So the female one used to be yellowish brown with four rings at black spot, and which used to have a tuft of hairs which is said to be found in the eggs, and male which is smaller and pale in color, and the four wings are said to be with the absence of black spot in them. And these are the pictures as well as their biological day life period. So the eggs used to in the day life period of around 5 to 8 days, and the female lays eggs at the age of 15 to 18 eggs per female. And the larva's life period is around 33 to 41 days, which used to have 5 larval stages, and the pupal stage. So they used to have a silkened cocoon, which used to rest at the period for 6 to 10 days, and the adult which used to brood 3 to 5 broods per year, and they are said to be also known as yellowish moth. So based on the stem borer's color, they used to have different scientific names, so I have listed them. So yellow stem borers Chiropaga insectulus, white stem borers Chiropaga innotata, stripped borers which is Chilo suprasalis, and dark head borer Chilo polychrysis, and pink stem borers Sesamia inference. So these are different borers which are present in rice and the different scientific names. And these are the pictures of yellow stem borer, white stem borer, pink stem borer, and remaining others. So while seeing about the stem borers economic threshold level, so 2 egg mosses per square meter is said to be the economic threshold level, and 10% of dead hearts and vegetative stage, or 2% of white ears at flowering stage. So if these threshold levels are, if the stage of damage of this these pests are increased, then there is a required action is said to be taken in the field level. And the management practices for stem borers are growing a resistant varieties, and also release of Trichogramma japonicum at 5 cc thrice at 37, 44 and 51 days is also a good one, and spraying of neem seed kernel extract at 5% in the field level is also one of the best practice we can able to do. And for monitoring these, we can able to set up light traps to attract and kill moths, and installation of pheromone trap at 12 per hectare is also the best one for monitoring as well as collecting of these insects. And while moving for the chemical insecticides, so the red one are importantly used for destruction of stem borers. So we can now able to move for the leaf folders or leaf rollers. So the scientific name is Marasmia pugnalis and Napalocrosis medinalis. So while seeing about the symptom of damage, the leaves are said to be folded by these insects longitudinally, and the larva which use it to remains inside them, and the larva scraps the green tissue of the leaves and become white and dry. During the Savary infestation, the whole field is used to exhibit the scorched appearance. So these are the damage symptoms made by the leaf folders. So while seeing about the distribution, it is said to be present in all states of Tamil Nadu. So the major damage conditions are said to be found in October and also in other rice growing districts. October onwards from the all rice growing districts. So the scientific names are Naplocrosis medinalis. So we must need to pronounce it the C in the silence ones, and the Marasmia paternalis, Marasmia ruralis, and the Marasmia exigua. So these are the scientific names of these insects. And while seeing about the identification of these insects, the egg is said to be flat and oval in shape and yellowish white in color, and the larva is said to be greenish transparent and adult moth with many dark wavy lines in center. So they also usually have dark band on the margin of wings. So these are the identification for this particular pest, and as well as into the distribution of these insects. They are mainly found in India, Sri Lanka, China, Japan, Madagascar, New Guinea, Pakistan, Bangladesh, as well as in Southeast Asian and Korean countries. While seeing about the host plant, they also have the host of around Avenia species, Musa species, and sugarcane family. And seeing about their biology, the egg period is around 4 to 7 days, and they use it to lay eggs in batches at 10 to 12 in linear rows, and the adult, so which is said to be 6 to have the life period of 6 to 8 days, and the pupation, which is said to be occurred only in the leaf fold stages, and the pupal period for them are 6 to 10 days, and the larval period is around 15 to 20 days. So the larva is said to be pale green and actively transplant, so which is a effective feeder on the leaves. So while seeing about the economic threshold level, the 10% of damaged leaves in vegetative stage as well as 5% of damage in flag leaves at flowering stage is the economic threshold level. Once if these level is said to be found, then the effective management practices must need to be taken. And the best management practices for these insects are use of resistant varieties as well as set up light trap to attract and kill the moths is also the effective one. And some of the other management practices are spraying of neem seed kernel extract at 5%, or else we can move for some of the insecticides such as carbaryl and chlorpyrifos, acetate, and carbosulfone. So these are effective against these insects, or else if we want to control by biological method, then we can be able to release trichogramma chironase at 5 cc, which is also thrice at 37, 44 and 51 days after the transplanting or sowing. And the other one is Galmich, where the scientific name is Orcialia oryzae. And while seeing about the symptom of damage, they use it to feed at the base of the growing shoot, and they use it to cause a formation of galls, which is said to be similar like onion leaf or silver shoot in the rice ones. So the infested fillers, they do not produce no panicles, so the whole plant must be the economic loss. So for identification of these galmiches, so at the egg stage, the eggs are said to be reddish and elongated, and tubular eggs which are said to be present at the near the edge of the leaf plate, and the larva which are maggot is said to be pale to red color, which is used to feed inside the galls, and the pupa which is used to pupate at the base of the gall and moves to tip of the gall for its pupation, and the adult which is said to be orange colored mosquito like fly, where we can found in the field. And the distribution, they are mainly occurred in India, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, Thailand and China, and particularly in Tamil Nadu. It is said to be found in Madurai, Ramnad, Tanjavur and Tiruchi district during the period of September to November. And some of the wild host plants are the wild species of rice are also affected by these galmiches, example Oryzae rupifogon, and grasses like and some other grasses species like Panicum species and cyanodactylon, which are also act as a host for these Calmiche. And while saying about the biology or rhizalis variety, the egg period is around 3 to 4 days and the female used to lay an eggs of about 100 to 300 oranges red elongated tube eggs at the site of leaf blade. And the maggot used to have a life period of around 7 to 9 days, and there is a larval dormancy if there is an unfavorable situation, and they are said to be pale to red in color, and the pupation which used to takes place around 4 to 6 days, and they are said to be pupate at the base of the gall, so the project outside during emergence, and they are said to be known as the mobile pupa once, and the adult which are said to be 5 to 6 days. So while seeing about their characteristics of identification, orange colored mosquito like fly, and they used to have a total life cycle of around 14 to 21 days. So the the first one I want to tell you is the economic threshold level, which is around 10% of silver shoots. And while seeing about the management, so we can go for resistant varieties for these Galmich, and we can also release some of the biological predators like platygetter, what I say, parasitic galls at 1 per 10 meter square or 10 days of on 10 days after transplanting is an effective method of management of these Galmiches. And we must need to harvest the crop and plow immediately, so as well as early plowing also reduces these Galmiches, and set up light trap with the infrared red light, which you use it to monitor the adult flies, is also the good one, or else we can be able to move for the insecticides. And the next one we are going to see is warming caterpillar or Spodoptera myuritia. So these insects are said to be the most dangerous one in the rice field. So because the larva used to cut the seedlings in large scale, and they used to show the appearance like cattle grazing in the field at night times. So they are also a gregarious feeder which used to march from field to field. So once if these kinds of pests are found in these field level, then the immediate management practices need to be made. So while seeing about the identification of these pests, the eggs are said to be laid in mosses on leaves, and they are said to be covered with the gray hairs, and the larval characteristics are which are said to be cylindrically dark to pale green color with the lateral lines along the body, and pupa which is said to be pupates in the earth and cocoon in soil adult. It is said to be a moth type, which is said to be medium sized stout body, and they are said to be have a dark brown color with a triangular spot on their four wings. So these their distribution are said to be found in India as well as the Southeast Asian countries, Eurasia, Australia and Africa, and the host range is rice, maize, sorghum, wheat, barley and sugarcane. And while seeing about their biology, the egg period which is said to be around 3 days, and they eggs are said to be found in mosses with a 100 to 200 in range, and the larval period is 20 to 25 days, which used to have a larval stage of 5 to 6 larval stages, and pupation which used to takes place at 8 to 12 days, which where it used to be pupates in soil as a earth and cocoon, and the adult is said to be stout and dark brown. And while saying about the distribution, the appears sporadically in Madurai, Tanjavur as well as in Coimbatore districts in Tamil Nadu. And while seeing about the management practices, allowing ducks in the field to feed on the larvae is an effective one, or else we can be able to drain the water and spray chloropyrifos 80 ml plus 20 liter of water for 8 cents is an effective one, or else we can be able to kill the larvae by kerosinating the water, which you can be able to cause them to suffocate. And these are some of the best methods, or else we must need to go for flood the nursery to expose the hidden larvae, and which make them move from the surface so the birds can able to pick and eat them. So the next one is rice case worm. So the scientific name of rice case worm is Nymphula dipunctanalis. So the symptoms of the rice case worms are they used to feed on the green tissue of the leaves, and which is said to be become a whitish papery structures. So while seeing about these rice case worm, they are said to be tubular cases around the tillers by cutting the apical portion of the leaves. So they are said to be floating like tubular cases on the water. So while seeing about the identification of insect pest, the larva, which is said to be pale translucent green with the orange head, it is said to be having a filamentous gills on the sides of the body, and the adult one where the mouth is said to be delicate white mouth with pale brown wavy markings on the wings. So the distribution is said to be found in all the rice growing districts, and it is also even found in the stagnant water places. So while seeing about the distribution worldwide, it is said to be found in India, Southeast Asia, as well as in Australia, and the host preference of these rice case worms, they are said to be found in Panivaragu and Brachia mutica and Cypress rhodanta species, and their biology, they used to have a period of around 2 to 6 days and the larval period is around 14 to 20 days, and their special characteristics are they are used to have a filamentous gills, so which has to be semi-aquatic, so they can able to even live in go in the water, and they also used to have life in leaf cases, and the pupation period is around 4 to 7 days where they used to be found inside the leaf cases, and the adult the life period is around 10 days, and they are said to be white with wave margins with black spots on their forewings, and seeing about these case worms, so they are said to be differentiated from insect pests by two ways. They used to have a layer-like appearance on the removed plant tissues, and the damage pattern is said to be not uniform throughout the feet. Is also the damage cases found in these worms, and the management practices for them are 250 ml of kerosene to the standing water, or else we can able to make spray monocrotopause at 500 ml per hectare. So these are some of the pictures to kill and identify the case worms. So pass the rope to dislodge them from the leaves, and release of hydrophilic beetles, which can use to prey on the case worms, is an effective one. And the other thing we are going to move is rice skippers, where the scientific name is Pilopidus mantias, and the symptoms of the damage are the edge of the leaves are fastened with the webbing, and they used to have a blackbird loading of leaves, and the caterpillar which used to feeds from margin to inwards is the effective symptoms of the rice skippers. And identification of these insect pest larva, which is said to be pale green with the constrictor neck, and the adult butterfly which used to have brown colored wings and a curved antenna in them, and the distribution, it is said to be found in all rice growing areas. And while seeing about the rice skipper, the in distribution in whole world, it is said to be found in India, Southeast Asia, China and Africa, and the host range are rice, sugarcane, maize and cypnodon species. And while seeing about the biology, the eggs are said to be laid in singly on leaf plate, and the egg period is around 3 to 6 days, and the larval period is around 13 to 26 days, where they used to have a constricted neck. So as shown in the picture, and the pupation which is said to be around 7 to 12 days, and the adult butterfly which is said to be a brown colored butterfly in nature, the rice skipper used to show. And seeing about the rice haunt caterpillar, so Melanthis leda is a me, so it is said to be having a white spot with dark brown circles on the brown forewings as well as the hind wings. So while seeing about the damage, they used to feed on the leaf plates of rice, and they are said to be deforated from margin to tip irregularly. While seeing about the identification of insect pests, eggs which are said to be white singly laid on the leaves, and the larva which is said to be lightly flattened with two red horn which is said to be processed on the head, and two yellow processes in anal end, and a pupa where there is a chrysalis which is used to suspend from the leaf, and the adult where they used to have a large wings with having black yellow spot like spot one on each of the forewing. So these are the pictures of horned caterpillar Melianthes ismini. So these are the pictures, and while seeing about the distribution, is said to be found in all rice growing places, and most severely it is found in Tiruchi districts. And next, while distribution, it is said to be found in all over India, and the host species are rice, millet, sugarcane. And while seeing about the biology, their egg period is around 4 to 7 days, and they are said to be laid in batches of 10 to 12 in linear rows. So, and the larval period is around 15 to 20 days. They used to have three larval stages, and the color is pale green and actively and translucent. And the pupation, which is to be taken in the leaf fold, and adult one, which is to live for around 6 to 8 days. And the next one we are going to see is yellow hairy caterpillar. The scientific name is Passeres pinnulata, and the symptom is the caterpillar, which is to cause defoliation. While seeing about the larval characteristics, they are said to be yellowish brown with red stripes. So they are said to be have an orange head and tuft of hairs all over the body, of which two in the anterior region and one in the posterior region are said to be prominent one. Pupa, which is said to be pale with a cocoon of silk and a frass attached to the leaf. And adult moth is stout with a straw colored forewings with a bipectinate antenna. And the next one, some of the pests are grasshoppers, so which are said to be the leaf feeders. So base the normal grasshopper scientific name found in rice are Hieroglypus banyan, and short-horned grasshoppers are Oxa nitidola. While seeing about the damage symptoms, they are said to be irregularly feed on seedlings and leaf blade, and they use it to cut the stem at the panicle stage, which used to cause major loss for the farmers. And they are completely defoliated the plants, leaving only the midribs. And the other grasshoppers, while seeing about the characteristics, so the larger grasshopper, which used to have one brood in a year, as well as the smaller one, Oxa nitidola, which used to breed throughout the years. And seeing about the nimble characters, they also to breed on grasses or else in paddy. And the adult, which is said to be adult characteristics, the longer one, which used to be 1 to 1.5 inch long, and they are said to be transversely direct lines on the prothorax. And while seeing about the short Oxa nitidola, it is said to be 1 inch long and has a longitudinal black streak on either side of the thorax. So while seeing about the distribution in Tamil Nadu, it is said to be found in all districts of Tamil Nadu, and it is also a serious pest in Kerala. And the next one is piney beetle, as well as rice hipsa. So the scientific name is Dicladipsa armigera. So while seeing about the symptoms of damage, the adult used to feed on the chlorophyll by scraping and causing white parallel streaks on the leaves, white patches along with long axis of leaves, grub mine into the leaves and makes blister near leaf tips. While seeing about the identification of insect pigs, the larva, which is said to be grub, is said to be minute and flat and yellow one, and the adult, which is said to be blue and black shiny beetle with spines on the thorax as well as in elytra. So these are the pictures of the beetle. And the rice hipsa beetle, so they are said to be found in the global level at Bangladesh, Burma, South China, India, West Malaysia, Nepal, Pakistan, Sumatra, Thailand, as well as in West Iran. And the host plants are primarily rice, but also feed on other grasses like Cynodon, Dactylon, and Brachyra mutica. So, but while feeding on those species, they do not build up the population. And some of the biological things we must need to know about these rice hipsa beetle are: in eggs, they used to have a period of around 4 to 5 days, and the larval period is 7 to 12. Pupation takes at 4 to 5 period of time, 5 days. And the adult, so they used to have 6 generations per year, is also we must need to know about these beetle. And they used to have a hot spiny elytra shaped structures. So while seeing about the distribution only in Tamil Nadu, it is said to be found in all districts, but they are mainly reported in Salem and Ramana districts. And the management is leaf tip containing blotching mites to be need to be destroyed, and manual collection and killing of beetle is an effective one using the hand nets, and or else we can able to move for the chemical sprayings like monophos, or else we can able to dust lindane at 30 kg per hectare at least 2 times with an interval of 40 days is also an effective one. And the other important pest in rice is hole maggot, which is Hierlia sazaki. So while seeing about these symptoms, they are said to be yellowish with long marginal blotching with a white hole on the leaf surface is an effective is an important symptom in hole maggot. And the identification of pest maggot, which are said to be yellowish white in color, and the adult, which is said to be small, dull and gray color. And the economic threshold level is 25% of damaging leaf, So it is, if it increases, then we must need to go for the management practices of remove the alternate host and adjust the time of planting, as well as the optimum recommendation of potash fertilizers is also an important one. And also we can move for insecticide spraying like chlorpyrifos and fipronil, and some other minor pests are blue beetle as well as rice root weevil. So, and the root feeders found in rice are rice root weevil with rice root grub and harvested termites. So, the I have also given you the integrated pest management in rice. So, the cultural method for in rice or trimming and plastering of bund of rice, which you use to expose the eggs of harvester and eliminate the bug breeding in grasses, and clip the tip of the seedling before transplanting, so it can able to prevent the carry of egg mosses of rice yellow stem borer from nursery to main field. And we can able to give a rogue space of 30 cm at a 2 point every 5 meter, reduces the damage by BPH and rodents, and also avoid use of excessive fertilizers. And the mechanical methods are setting of light traps and bow trap to kill rodents, and set up a pheromone traps, and dig out the rat burrows and destroy the rats and young ones at the beginning of the season. And the biological methods are release of Trichogramma japonica and Trichogramma chylonis, and plaster varicae parasite galls, and also put up owl perches at which used to reduce rat damage. And some of the plant products we can able to use in the field are neem seed kernel, except, and we can also go for spraying botanicals like NSKE and Prosopis julifera and Ipomia carnea leaf extract is also an effective one. And or else we can able to move for the chemical method as the final one in the management, integrated pest management. So we can able to use insecticides based on the economic threshold level. So I have given the lecture notes in description. So please comment about the video and join us in the Instagram page. So if you like the video, like it and share it with your friends and subscribe to BS Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch up in next videos.